Hello everyone, in today's tutorial, we'll see how to create these torn paper effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go ahead and open Photoshop. And then I will go to File, New. Then we'll create a new document using 2600 pixels for the width and 4000 pixels for the height. And I will keep the resolution set to 72 pixels and RGB in the color mode. And I will press OK. Alright, so the first thing that we are going to do is to create a new layer. And then I will rename this layer to Base Image. After that, I will right click and choose convert to smart object, and then I will delete this background in here. Alright, now I will right click on this base image and then I will choose edit content. Alright, now I will go ahead and open the image that I want to use, which is this one. So I will take it and drag it to the image base placeholder in here for the smart object, and after that I will resize it. And I will one click on this check mark to commit the change. Alright, next I will right click and rasterize layer. This is not necessary, only if you want your PSD not to be that large. It's better to rasterize the layers that are smart objects. Alright, after that I will close this tab and I will make sure to press yes to save the changes to the smart objects in here. As you can see, we have our image in here saved. Alright, next I will apply a filter. So I will go to filter and I will choose camera raw filter. Alright, the only thing that I want to apply in this camera raw is the effect in here. So I will open it and I will add a grain. I will add quite a bit, like 40. Alright, as you can see, if I zoom in, you can see before and after, a lot of grain. I mean, this is up to you if you want to add more or add less, it depends on you. And I will press OK. Alright, now I want to this space to be black and white. So I'm gonna go to adjustment and I will choose gradient map. And in this gradient, it's a little bit darker. I want it to be a little bit softer than this. So I will open the gradient in here. And the black, I will double click on this stop color in here. And I will change the black. I'm gonna only change the brightness of the black to 8 and I will press OK and OK, and as you can see, looks much better now. Alright, next it's time for us to open the second image that we want to place in here. So I will go ahead, or actually I want to make it as a smart object too. So I'm gonna create a new layer and I will call this second image, and then again I will right click and I will choose convert to smart object, and again right click and edit contents. Alright, so let's go and open the second image, which is this one. So we'll take it and open it in here. Alright, for this one I want the flower to be around here, but it's okay, we can just open it and then resize it later inside our document. So I will just one click on this check mark and then I will right click again and rasterize layer, and then close this and make sure to press yes to save. Alright, now we have our second image, as you can see, and I'm gonna apply a little bit of grain too, the same as the base image. So I will go to filter and again camera raw filter. Alright, so in the effects in here, I'm gonna put the same amount, like 40 in the grain, and I will press OK. Alright, now it's time for us to open the torn papers that we have in here. It's only one, we're gonna duplicate it. So I'm just gonna take it and drag it in here. And I will make it a little bit bigger. And I will one click on this check mark. And again, I will right click and I will choose a rasterize layer, because I don't want to replace this. I want it to be here permanently. So I'm just gonna put it here, and I will hide this second image for now so I can see where I want the tone cut to be. So I want it to be somewhere around here. All right, and I will duplicate this. So I'm just gonna take it and bring it in this new layer, and I will call this tone paper too. All right, now I'm gonna press Ctrl T or Command T, and then I will right click and choose flip vertical. As you can see, this will flip it, and I will put this in here. But I think I will flip it horizontally too, because I don't want to be, this is the same in here. I think this is better like this. All right, something like that. And I will press on this check mark to commit the change. I will select the tone paper, the first one, and I will bring it a little bit up. All right. Now I want to reveal these flowers in here, these daisy flowers. I want them to be in the middle in here. So let me first place it to be just right here. I think I want them to be somewhere like that. Maybe I'm gonna press Ctrl T or Command T, and that will make it a little bit bigger, somewhere around here. All right, I think like this is perfect, and I will one click on this check mark. All right, so for us to do that, we need to make a layer mask on this second image in here. So I will one click on this layer mask, and then I will select this second one in here. I will load the selection of this torn paper. And to do that, you can just press Ctrl and one click, and this will load the selection. I'm sorry, it's this one. So Ctrl and one click to load the selection, or you can just go to, while the torn paper in here is selected, you can just go to select and choose load selection, and make sure it's in here. So the channel is torn paper too, and press OK, and this will load it. All right. So while we are selecting this torn paper too, we will go and select our magic wand tool, and I will one click in here, and this will select the rest of the tone paper in here that is transparent. And then I will select the second image, and I will make sure that I'm selecting the layer mask, and I will just press delete. But make sure that your foreground color is white, and then press delete. And as you can see, this will delete everything in here. So we're gonna do the same for this one too. So we're gonna load the selection, we're gonna press Ctrl or Command and one click, and this will load the selection. And while we are selecting the tone paper layer in here, I can just use in my magic wand tool and one click, and this select the rest that is up in here. All right, so I will do the same. I will go to the layer mask for the second image, and I will just hit delete or return. And as you can see, this will delete everything in here. And then I'm going to press Ctrl D or Command D to deselect. All right, as you can see, now we have our effect. If you don't like the placement of the base image, you can just select it and then press Ctrl T or Command T, and you can make it bigger or smaller as you want. For this case, I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger, just like that. All right, I think I'm happy with this, and I will one click on this check mark. Alright, the last thing that I want to do is to add a little bit of adjustment. So I'm gonna go to adjustment, and then I will select solid color, and then I will choose this orangey yellowish color, not that saturated, something in the middle like this, and I will press OK, and then I will change the blending mode of it to exclusion, and I will drop down the opacity to 10%, just to give it this sepia kind of feel color. Alright, I think it looks good, but you know, it's up to you. You can put anything in here, and you can put anything in here too. As long as you have a layer mask, you can just change to whatever you want. I'm gonna show you how to do that. So I think this one looks good. Alright, now let's see for us to how we can replace the image to another image if you want. Alright, so I'm gonna double click on this base image in here, or you can just right click and choose edit content again. And then I will open another image. For this time, I want to open this one in here. So I'm just gonna take it and open it in here and resize it, something like this. And I will one click on this check mark. And then I will right click and choose again, rasterize layer. And then I will close it and make sure to press yes to save the changes. All right, now we have our base image in here, as you can see. And I want to change this too. So I'm just gonna go to the second image and you can just double click on here or right click and edit content. For this time, I will just double click in here and as you can see, it will open the same tab. And then I will go and open the image that I want, which is this one. So I'm just gonna take it and open it in here, resize it. All right, and I will one click on this check mark. And then I will right click again and choose the rasterize layer. After that, I will close it and make sure to press yes to save. All right, as you can see, we don't have what we want. I want this to be placed in here. And also I want this to be black and white and I want this to be in color. So to do that, I'm just gonna unlink the layer mask from these two. I will just one click on this link and this will unlink them. Now I can transform this without affecting the layer mask in here. I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command T and I will take this and bring it down. That's right here. Maybe make it a little bit bigger. All right. And I will one click on this check mark. And then I will go and select the base image. And again, I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command T and resize it to something like this. All right, I think it looks good like this. I want it to be just like this. All right. And for us to change the black and white, we can just take this gradient map and put it on top of this and then make sure to clip it to the second image by pressing Alt or Option, or you can right click and choose Create Clipping Mask and this will clip it to the layer underneath of the gradient map in here. Alright, I think it looks good. So I think I want to resize it even more, so I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command T while I'm selecting the image and resize it to be exactly where I want it, something in here. Alright, something like that. Alright, now we have our second effect. This can see it was very easy to do using the same document and it looks very, very cool. And that will be all. I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. If you try it, make sure to tag me in Instagram or whatever platform you are using. And don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know wait for more tutorials to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.